Today we are going to deal with the part of the pressure and proportion, only proportion. What the proportion means? When we write four quantities, for example, A, B, C, D, these are non-zero quantities. When we say that A is to B will be equal to C is to D, that time we can say that A, B, C, D are in proportion. We can try to understand with the help of example. Suppose four quantities are given, 5, 10, 6, 12. This quantity is called as first quantity, this is called as second quantity, this is called as third quantity, this is called as fourth quantity. When can we say that these four numbers are in proportion? For that we can check by two ways. One is first quantity upon second quantity, 5 comes up, 5 comes up, and second quantity is third upon fourth, that is 6 1 the 6 2 the. So 1 upon 2 1 upon 2. When the simplest form is same, we can say that 5 10 6 12 are in proportion. Means when first quantity upon second quantity equal to third quantity upon fourth quantity, we can say that the numbers are in proportion. Another way to find whether the numbers are in proportion, the middle two numbers, they are called as mean, and the numbers which are at the end, they are called as extremes. When product of mean should be equal to product of extremes, and another way is first quantity upon second quantity equal to third quantity upon fourth quantity. Again we can do in detail about this, that when numbers are in proportion, question will be asked in this way, that four numbers are in proportion, and another is when these three numbers are in proportion. In this case we can write A upon B equal to C upon D, and in this case A upon B equal to B upon C. This proportion is called as continued proportion. What is the difference between these two proportions? In this case, the numbers first upon second, third upon fourth quantity. But here the number which is in as a mean, that we have picked two times. So therefore A upon B equal to B upon C, and it is part of the continued proportion. In this case, we can write A into B equal to B into C. In this case, B square equal to AC, or in short we can say that mean square equal to product of extremes. This you can solve it by another method. That method is called as K method. Means taking K as a constant. So in proportion, A upon B equal to C upon D equal to K. K as constant. We can write A upon B equal to K as well as C upon D equal to K. Therefore, A equal to DK and C equal to DK. In case of continued proportion, the case will be little bit different. A upon B equal to B upon C equal to K. A upon B equal to K. B upon C equal to K. It means B equal to CK and A equal to BK. Still, we have to substitute this value of B over here. Therefore, A equal to CK square. So, difference between both of them, this is just a proportion and this is a continued proportion. In proportion, A upon B equal to C upon D means due to cross multiplication over here, A into B equal to B into C. This is without the K method, and with K method, A upon B equal to C upon D equal to K. K is a constant, therefore each term will be equal to K. Each term will be equal to K. Therefore A upon B equal to K, C upon D equal to K, A equal to BK, C equal to BK. There is no re-substitution in the just proportion. But when we talk about continued proportion, in continued proportion, the mean has to be taken two times, therefore A upon B equal to B upon C. Without K method, we will write B square equal to AC, means mean square equal to product of extremes. So A upon B equal to B upon C equal to K. A upon B equal to K, B upon C equal to K. In this case, B equal to CK, A equal to BK. But we are going to re-substitute the value, that is A equal to, in place of B, CK. CK into K is CK square. A equal to CK square. So in this way, in exam, they will ask us without K method or with K method. Or they may just mention solve the example. So you can use whichever method is easy, that method you can use.